Hello, welcome to this channel Gain Java Knowledge, and today in this video we will see how to deploy containerized Spring Boot application with Docker into EC2 instance. So first what we will do, we will create one Spring Boot application and then we will create its Docker image and then we will push this Docker image into Docker Hub and then we will use this Docker image into our EC2 instance from Docker Hub. So what first thing we need to do? First we need to create one Spring Boot application. If you want to learn how to use Spring Boot with Docker, then you can go to description. I have given the link in description, so you can watch this video and learn how to use Spring Boot with Docker. And in this Spring Boot application, I have created one class that is Spring Controller. And in this Spring Controller, I have created simple REST endpoint that will return the message in the form of string that I will pass from a path variable. And here I have also created one Docker file, and this Docker file contains JDK version, that is OpenJDK 8, and its add target of jar file and exposing on the port number 8092 and the entry point that is given here. And here we can see my pom.xml file, and in my pom.xml file here I have defined the jars, that is Spring Boot starter, and here is the plugin that will be used to push the Docker image into Docker Hub. So when the image will be created, it will automatically push into Docker Hub. So here I have added the plugin group id com.spotify. Docker Maven plugin I have used, and the version is 1.3.7, and the goal is build and push. And this is the my Docker Hub credential, that is my Docker ID, and this is the repository name that I will create, and this is the project build file name that I have defined here. Spring Boot Docker EC2.jar file will be created, and the same I have used here, Spring Boot Docker EC2. So now I will go to my Docker Hub and will create the repository Spring Boot Docker. And here I am login, and now I will go and create a new repository. So here I will click on create repository, and this is my Docker ID, and here I will create the name for repository, Spring Boot Docker. And description is optional, and it will be public or private, we can choose anyone. Now click on the create. So my Spring Boot Docker repository is created. Now I will go to my Eclipse, and here we can see this is my Docker ID and my repository name. So now what I will do, I will push my Docker image to my Docker Hub. So first we need to create Docker image. So I will go run as and click on Maven build. And in Maven build, we need to define the goal. And here we will define the goal as clean package docker file colon push. Then it will create the image and automatically push to our Docker Hub. So now I will click on apply and run. So it will take time to push the image on Docker Hub. Now it's downloading the jars and dependency for OpenJDK 8. Now here we can see the image is pushed, and now we will go to our Docker Hub, and here we will refresh it and check the Spring Boot Docker repository. And here we can see last published 2 minutes ago, and the tag, the version is 0.01, have pushed to our Docker Hub. Now we will go to our Amazon console and create the EC2 instance so we can use this Docker Hub image into our EC2 instance. And here we will choose EC2 virtual server in the cloud. And here we need to click on running instances. You do not have any running instance in this region, so click on launch instance. And here we need to select Amazon Linux AMI. So select this one. That is Amazon Linux AMI 2018. And here now we need to choose an instance type. So here I will select general purpose free tier eligible and click on review and launch. And here you can see AMI details and then click on launch. Here you need to choose an existing key pair. So here we will create a new key pair and we will download the key pair, but first we need to define the name for key pair, Amazon key pair. And here I will click on download key pair. Now key pair is downloaded and we can show in folder, and here we can see .pem is the extension for this key pair. Now click on launch instance. So here we can see the message, your instance is now launching. Now click on services and click on EC2, and here I will click on instances, and here we can check our instance. So here we can see the instance that is running. Here we can see instance ID 80F08F and the instance is running and status check initializing. And here we can see the details about our instance, that is description and status checks. Now I will click on connect, and now we need to use Now here we need to connect with our EC2 instance. If we are using Mac, then we can directly using SSH, but if we are working on Windows, then we just need to copy this instance from here up to .com. So here I will copy it, and we need to download the PuTTY, because here we are using PuTTY. And I have already downloaded, so I will just open it, click on PuTTY, and in PuTTY I will just paste here this path and will add the setting name, that is Amazon pair, and click on save, so it will be saved. Now if I will try to open, it will not give me permission. So it will, I will click on yes, and here this will not connect because we are not using the key that we have downloaded. So I need to go to PuTTYGen, that we need to download also. So I will click on PuTTYGen, and here we need to generate the PPPK key, that will be private key. So here I will click on load, and here I will go to my downloads and select the files, all files, and here we can see the download pair key, and click on this file and open it, and here we can see successfully imported foreign key. Click on OK and save this private key. Click on yes, and here you need to define the name for this private key, Amazon private key. So I will save it in download folder. save it, and now I can close it and okay. Now I will go to my putty again and will load this key. So first I will load this configuration that I have already saved, and now I will go to connection and open SSH and go to auth, and here I will click on browse, and here I need to select download folder, and in download folder the key that we have saved, click on open and open. Now we can see it will connect with our instance. Now here we can see it is connected with EC2 instance. So now we need to go for admin. So here I will type sudo hyphen I. Now I will be admin. Here I will update all the folders, sudo yum update y. Now I need to install the Docker. So here I will type sudo yum install docker. So it will be asked for permission, click on y and it will download it. Now we need to start the Docker after installing it. So here I will type, so here after installing we need to start our service, sudo service docker start. So it's starting the configuration service and starting the Docker, and it's showing OK. Now we need to run our image that we have installed in our Docker Hub, that we need to run. So here I will copy from here, I will go here 0.01 and click see all, and from here I will copy this path, copy pull command copied. So this command will be used to pull the Docker image from Docker Hub. Now I will go to my instance and paste here Docker pull and click here, and it's pulling the image. Now what we need to do, now we need to run this image. So here I will just paste here, I have defined docker run hyphen p, the port number that we need to communicate with, that is 80 and 8080. But here we can see in our Docker Hub, in our EC2 instance we just created, and this is our instance that is running. And here we can see in details, that is the security group where we have defined the port number, and here we can see in security group there is nothing. So this is a one security group. And here we can see inbound rules, it is just using the port number 22. And here I will click and can edit the inbound rules, and we can create one more security group. So here I will click on security groups and click on create security group. And here we can define any name for this security group, or we can use already existing security group also. So here I will use already existing security group. So now here we will select anywhere. So here we will just click on this and click on add rules. So first rule is already defined. So next one is we will select here HTTP and select here anywhere, and click on the next rule. And here I will select HTTPS, and here click on custom and select anywhere, and add rules we have done, and click on the save rules. And here we can see in this security group we have added three rules, that is SSH, HTTP at 18.0 port, 80 port, and HTTPS is 443 port number, and save these rules. Now inbound security group rules successfully modified. Now here we can see these rules that we have defined. Now I will run this Docker image. So here I have typed the command docker run hyphen p and port number that we are using 8080, and 8080 that we will define in application dot properties file. If we have not defined, then it will automatically by default pick the 8080. So here we can modify by typing server dot port and can define anything. So here I have defined docker run hyphen port number 8080, and 8080 that we have defined in our application dot properties file. If we have not defined, then it will default pick up 8080. And here we need to define name for this image, Spring Boot Docker, and this is my Docker ID, and this is the repository that I am using, and this is the version, that is 0.01. Here we can see our Spring Boot application is running. And now I will go to browser and check the my REST endpoint is working or not. So here I will go. First I will check the IP that we need to use. Click on instances. And instances, here we can see the details. That is description. We can use public DNS IPv4, or we can use IPv4 public IP also. So here I will using this. So copy it and go to browser. And here I will type the IP and port number 80 and the URL of my API, api/message, and it will be the message getting response. Now I will hit, and here we can see the message that we have sent, we returned in response also. So this everything that we have covered. First we create Spring Boot application, after that we create the Docker image, and then push this Docker image to Docker Hub. Then we are using this Docker image from Docker Hub by using EC2 instance. Okay. Thanks for watching this video.